Hi, my name is Skyler Smith. I work with the integrator and technical support team here at Apogee Instruments, and we're here to talk about connecting our SP-214 pyranometer to the SMA cluster controller, very popular controller for use in commercial solar applications. The SP-214 is an irradiance sensor in order to see the watts per meter squared available from the sun. So the first thing to note is the SP-214 comes like this with a 4-inch pigtail to connect to. So the sensor does need to be powered, 24 volts power supply. So you need to know where your power supply is and then how far away that is from your X8 terminal on the cluster controller. Depending upon the distance, you may need to split the jacket like so. And we have the red and black over here that will power the sensor, and the green and white, which are the sensor output that will connect into the controller. So we'll go ahead and right here, in our example, we'll connect the red into the positive on the power supply. So we just slide that down in there. And this is just a regular screw on terminal. So we will slide it in and tighten that down. And then the black will go in the negative. And same thing, we will just tighten him down. Okay. And then over here on the controller itself, we are on X8 and the top row is A2. So we're going to go in A2 for the white conductor, A3 for the green conductor. And these are just push-in terminals, so they just push in. And then our shield, we will go into A4. Okay, so that's how you wire up the sensor itself. The next step is to change the insulation curve, and you do that through the user interface for the SMA cluster controller. And so once you have that interface pulled up on your computer, navigate to meteorology, and then go to environmental, and then go to irradiance sensor, and then go to characteristic curve. And when you're there, you just need to change it to 0 to 1250 watts per meter squared. And as a reminder, this is a 4 to 20 milliamp sensor. The other way that you can look at this is on the controller itself. If you scroll down a number of times, then you get to analog inputs. Analog current input number 1 on the top there is showing us what the data is reading from the sensor. And in our example here, it's reading 4.01 milliamp, which is correct for our studio. There is very little light. And if we hit down 2 more times, we can see the insulation converting that to 1 watts per meter squared, which should be correct. For normal applications, you'll probably be reading between 7 to 11 milliamps, depending on your time of day and location. That concludes our SP-214 pyranometer connecting to the SMA cluster controller. Be sure to watch our other segment on connecting our TS-100 aspirated radiation shield to the cluster controller to get very accurate ambient air temperature readings. Thank you.